Record button. Press and hold is switch between photo and video mode. Press once, means take a photo or start stop recording. Dial button, press twice to switch between the flight live view and real view in the goggles. Scroll up or down to tilt the camera before takeoff or during landing. Scroll the dial to switch between easy ACRO actions when easy ACRO is enabled. Press and hold the dial to recenter the cursor on the screen when using AR cursor. Mode button, press to switch between normal and sport mode. Press and hold for return to home, press mode or lock button once for cancel return to home. Joystick button, move up or down to make the drone ascend or descend. Move left or right to make the drone move left or right horizontally. Lock button, press twice to start motor, then press and hold to make drone take off. While the drone is hovering, press and hold to land and stop the motors. Press during flight to make the aircraft brake and hover in place. After gently pressing the accelerator to the first stop, you can adjust drone orientation by tilting the top of motion controller to the left or right. Drone will not fly forward at this time. Press the accelerator past the first stop to fly in the direction of the circle in the goggles. Press the accelerator forward to fly backward. Press the power button once to check battery level. If you press once and then press again and hold for 2 seconds, controller will power on. At the bottom of the controller is a USB Type-C slot for charging and upgrading the software. Let's upgrade the controller. In the description of the video you have a link where you can download DJI Assistant 2 to upgrade the controller. Download the program and install it. The program recognized the DJI account from my drone. If you don't have one, then create one. Connect controller with computer. I hope the video helped you. You can subscribe for free for new videos. The next video I will make is connecting Motion 3 controller with DJI Mini 4 Pro and then fly.